Hello, this is Dr. Glasbrenner from George Mason University, and in this video, we will learn how to use the unite function from the tidier package to combine several columns into a single column. The purpose of the unite function is to combine data from many columns into one column, which is the reverse of the separate function. The structure of the unite function is as follows. We pipe the data set into the unite function, and for the first input, we provide what we would like the name of the final united column to be. The subsequent inputs will be the names of the columns that we wish to unite into a single column. We can provide as many column names as we want. After listing the columns we want to combine, we then provide the SEP input, which specifies the symbol that will be placed between the values of the united columns. To illustrate how the unite function works in practice, we will consider the contents of Table 5, which is another way to organize the same subset of data from the 2014 World Health Organization Global Tuberculosis Report that we used in the gather, spread, and separate examples. Here we see that we have four columns: country, century, year, and rate. The century column is the first two digits of the full year, and the year column is the last two digits of the full year. Each cell under the rate column contains two pieces of information: the number of tuberculosis cases, and the total population for each country for a given year. These values are separated by the forward slash symbol. Storing data in the way shown does not satisfy the tidy data principles, hence, we would classify it as untidy. As a reminder, this is what the same data set would look like if the table was organized according to the tidy data principles. Our task is to use the unite function to reshape our data in the table from the previous slide so that it looks like the table shown on this slide. Note that, after we use the unite function, we would need to follow the same steps as discussed in the separate lecture to get back to the tidy form. This schematic illustrates how we will use the unite function to reshape Table 5. Note that the Table 6 label on the bottom right is a typo from the figure in the R for Data Science textbook. What we are doing here is taking the century and year columns and combining them into a new column named year. This is an operation that preserves all relationships in the data. Here is the code that implements the reshaping process we just saw in the schematic. We take Table 5 and pipe it into unite. For the first input, we write new, which will be the name of our final combined column. Next, we give the column names century and year as the second and third inputs. These are the names of the two columns in Table 5 that we wish to combine. We execute the command, and we end up with the following table. This is close to, but not exactly the same as what we wanted. Notice that the years under the new column have an underscore in between the first two and last two digits of the full year. We can fix this problem by specifying the SEP input. If we provide two double quotation marks to the SEP input, then this says that we do not want to use a joining symbol for the united columns. With that set, the full years listed under the new column look correct, and we finished uniting the columns. Two additional steps are needed to transform the table to the same starting point in the separate lecture. The new column needs to be renamed to year and converted into the integer data type. We can take care of both of these steps easily using the dplyr package. We pipe the result of the unite function into mutate. Inside mutate, we pass the input new equals as.integer open parentheses new close parentheses. Because the new column is specified on both sides of the equal sign, this will update the data for the new column in place, converting it to the integer data type. The result is then piped into the rename function, where we provide year equals new as our input. This input means we want to take the new column and change its name to year. We then execute this sequence of commands, yielding the following table, which is the same as Table 4, the starting point for the lecture on the separate function.